Sorry. Okay. Well, this is round one passion time, and we
round
are.
Round two.
Oh, yeah, round two. Sorry. And what our central question is how to draw like a realistic face, not just a face, but like one that looks pretty realistic. Now,
not like a stick figure.
Really, really hard to do that. So we decided like we could do some research and stuff. So most of the video is going to be looking at our paper, but we'll still be talking to you, but you just won't see our faces.
Okay. I'm gonna start out with drawing the head. Like the shape of the head. Anyway.
So you don't want to make it too much like a football. So
or
you can really start wherever. I'm gonna be doing a female. He's gonna be doing a male. Mikey will be right.
Oh, she made it do that in the head, yeah.
So I like to use really little lines like this. Like if I'm gonna make a line right here. Like, instead of just doing one line, I like to do a little line. Because I feel like I can get more depth in it. So right now, we don't need to worry about the hair just yet. I feel that kind of comes at the end for me. Even if I have to erase my ears a little, it's just nice. So I make, like, a flat kind of head. And then... So I'm going to start, I like to maybe just make it like quiet, like just the littlest line like this.
Drawing the eyes or the nose?
I'm starting with, like, I just want to get my guidelines because it helps so much on make.
I think the guidelines don't work for me.
Yeah, well, you can do any way you want. So, Mikey, tell us how you're going to do your eyes. You can start taking up the microphone now.
I'm going to do the eyes like this. So first when I do the eyes, I find where I would want them, so I imagine on my face, where would the eyes be? So about right here, and maybe right there, about right there, yeah. And I draw a curved line, not too far apart, and not too close to the sides, but not too close to each other. Then I draw, maybe that's a little too far apart.
So, yeah, since I'm doing a female, I'm going to make my eyelashes really stand out. Mikey, maybe not as much, but...
No, probably not. So then I'll draw, like, the bottom part of the eye right here. Like that. Okay, drawing eyes.
So, I like to draw the eyes, like, with just, like, so many different lines. There's like probably like over 50 little lines in my eyes. I just make so many little lines because if you don't do that, I think your eyes will look too like squarish and just not that right kind of oval-ish kind of shape where it makes it look really
like
realistic.
Sort of like this.
One of the most boldest, darkest parts I shade with my pencil and the entire thing is the pupil. It's so important for me to do that. It needs to stand out. It's huge to me. What about you, Mikey?
Yeah. Sometimes you have big pupils when you're like small pupils. But if you make your pupil like maybe too small, then it looks not, it just doesn't look right. If you make it too big, the eyes just don't look right either. So, that's it. Right. Apparently, your eyes are looking that way.
Mm-hmm, I gotta look towards you.
Alright, there or something.
So, if you wanna just see my drawing really quick like that, you can get a sense. And
my
then,
eyes.
This isn't just my complete head. Like, I'm gonna be erasing the cheeks and the.
Can you draw another eye?
Chin a bunch to get it even with the eyes and stuff.
I don't draw the chin that much. It always ends up looking wrong. So I don't usually draw that much of the chin.
So with the other eye, I'm just going to try to go a little faster.
Yeah. I'm just gonna change my first eye, the bottom of it a little bit so it's less arched.
And yeah, there we go.
Where's this little one?
It's just gonna be like the same exact thing.
That's a pretty similar.
You can keep going on to the nose, Nike. You
don't have to. I'm not good at the nose.
No, don't say that.
I'm good at the ears, but not the nose.
Well, then why don't you do the ears now?
Well, I'm just gonna get the nose over with. That's not bad, that bad of a nose.
With the eyelashes, I like to make like a bunch so it just looks like a thick bar and then erase. So some don't, so only some stand out, and then go over them a little
How
again.
How do I finish this nose?
That way you can really make them look nice. So.
Forgot how to finish the nose.
So now what I've done right here is, since I made my eyes now, I do not like the look of my head. So I'm gonna start arranging everything again.
So I'm gonna go crafty for a sec so I can check the nose again.
Yeah.
Okay.
So Mikey's just gonna check something.
Crafty. Just to make sure I'm doing the nose right.
Why don't you show them the entire thing? So,
So close this. Okay, I can't do it at this angle.
There you go.
Okay.
Okay, and make sure. So, Mikey's just gonna look at something really quick.
Check on you.
I'm gonna keep trying, and I'll show you.
I'm not gonna do much, right? Well, that's kind of a.
You gotta remember to move this down, okay?
Okay.
And the ears. Oh, with the ears, do compressed. Okay, right. So with my nose, I don't want to make it too thin, but I don't want to make it too thick. So I erase a lot of times to make sure I get the right thickness. And what I use for the thickness is the eyes. Nose is always right in between your eyes.
I'm gonna do the ears. I'm really good at the ears, but kind of get hard with the lines in between, inside the ear. But you gotta get the shape right too, otherwise your ears look like goblin ears.
Mm-hmm.
These are bad.
With the pointing top. You don't want that.
Your outline. Now I gotta get the lines to make it work.
So since I made my nostrils look, I'm even making the nose more thin now. Now I'm gonna make it longer. Okay, there's your nose for me.
Nah. First is not so good. Look, I'm just gonna have to turn around for a sec to draw the second ear.
Okay, so now I'm gonna move on to my ears too. I just like to make this.
Make them all too high up on the head.
I always line my ears up with my eyes.
Okay. Which I maybe didn't do enough. My first year, so I'm gonna erase that one eventually.
And then the ears always have those lines, like those, which are really hard to draw, so you just sum up some lines. You can see right here. This is my drawing so far.
I'm gonna change my first year, go back so it's not too high up on the head of my person.
Now I'm gonna do my mouth.
Your person's name?
I'll try to think of one. So now I'm gonna do my mouth. This is how I start. You just make a line literally just like a tiny line right here, like that. So then what I do is I just like start curving up towards the nose, but then I quickly curve it down and make a little M, curve it up again, and then go down.
Why not do so good with the ears this time?
I think they're great. You can always adjust the size. Yes. Then I go like this. Now that's not it yet though, obviously. So I'm gonna go like this now. And then I'm gonna erase the bottom. Actually. Mouths are the most challenging thing for me. So I had to do a lot of research on these because when the teeth go into the mouth, they have to be the right size. It's hard.
The teeth?
Yeah, when I draw.
I always make my eyes too wide. Can't get the size right after. See, this right here.
It's okay.
In the right, like, proportions and size.
So that is a hard mouth. Like, it already looks like the person has like crooked teeth kind of. It's really hard, but I'm just gonna keep it how it is.
Yeah, and these braces.
Now I'm gonna go a little on the shading. So I'm just gonna start shading down because the light is coming and shining onto her.
Okay. So, yeah. I
did this mistake right here. With my shading, I made straight lines. That's not what I want. So what I'm gonna do with the shading to make it look realistic is I'm gonna go like this. I'm gonna go.
We gotta fix this guy now.
And then I'm gonna erase and smear. Right
on this guy's mouth.
Seen a lot of videos and really got inspired. I got inspired with the shading in this one video where the light is on his cheek. I'm probably not even gonna keep this, but like you can see how the shading works. It's hard. Now I'm for the hair, I erase the top of my head. So get out the forehead. And then I make it all weird because I got a strange shape on however my hair is going.
I just made the mouth work. So, but first of all, do not put the hair on top of the head. That's not what you're supposed to do.
Yeah, because then it will look like you have your hair, like, all combed up, kind of. That's why I erased my forehead. If I did it a different way, it'd be very different.
You can draw the line here, and it makes him have some hair on top of his head, without actually drawing it on top of his head. Then that makes him look.
I don't want to make my hair too squarish, like
now. Don't
make a rectangle, so I kind of curve it and wave it a lot. Hair is always wavy to me.
Mm-hmm. Poor this guy.
So I'm erasing one of my
lips. He's got pretty good hearing though.
I'm erasing my ear because the hair is covering over it. Like this. And then you might erase part of the cheek.
I think I'm gonna invent a pencil that like you can shade something, like on something, and then you shade it on your paper. And then you see that thing that you shaded.
Cool. That was cool.
Because if I wanted to draw a realistic face, I'd just shade you. And then I'd shade it under my paper, and voila, I have a
shot. Then my face would be all dirty, so.
Yeah.
So, it's not, like, a realistic as
if. It's not as realistic.
As if we took a picture.
But, no, it's not that. It's not
good enough. It's good enough. Yeah. It took a lot of research on that.
Pretty good.
So I'm gonna make my hair now like this.
Should I give this guy some earrings?
Yeah, I think so.
Maybe.
I can.
You sure you?
Nah.
Hat?
Nah.
Nope. I don't even know how to make a hat on him. I could give him a beard.
Yeah, why don't you try that, Mikey?
No, I'm not even. Nah.
Whoa. So notice I'm not coloring like I would with a marker, like I just like scribble. I'm just like making long streaks and then scribbling every once in a while. I'm not just like making those long streaks because it wouldn't look like that wavy. We even want that little white in the paper to make it look like there are actually strands of hair. It's really important.
Well, here's mine. I could add a mustache.
I don't think so.
Well, here's my finished face. Name's gonna be Jimmy, and then his last name's gonna be John. His middle name's gonna be, I don't know.
I'll show you my face when I'm ready.
Bruce Wayne.
Bruce Wayne.
Yeah, he has two middle names.
Or is he Bruce Wayne Jr., Batman's son?
I'm gonna make him actually Bruce Wayne John. And then his middle name will be Kal-El. So it will be Batman and Superman, and his last name will be John. Well, no. Bruce Wayne and John and Kal-El are his middle names.
So mine is right here.
Let's see what they look like compared. Right. Different.
Mm-hmm. So, okay.
So... that's our Passion Time video. Thank you for watching. Bye.